All right, so I'm going to attempt to try to do this here at the Oak Brook Polo Training Academy. We'll see how that goes. I'm Tom Barnish, Chicago scene out in Bolingbrook at the Academy. I'm going to talk to Jenna and Turner. They're going to give me lessons on how to do this and not fall off the horse. Everything from learning how to get on this horse here, which I think is called Thunderbolt, to shooting a mallet correctly so you can score. And however this game works, I'm going to learn it for the Chicago scene. So let's do it. So I had no idea that was an indoor ball and there's an outdoor ball. I had no idea, but Jenna and Turner here are gonna help explain the art of polo, how to play and the whole thing, because you guys have a clinic and that's what I'm about to do, right?
That's correct. So we have our Intro to Polo clinic. We're gonna have another one of these. We have them all summer. Those are great for people who want to come out, try polo. Maybe you don't have any riding experience. Maybe you have riding experience. It's for anybody. Polo is a great sport. We're accepting everybody, so.
So you guys take people like me who have been on a horse maybe three times in his life and he's 41 years old, and you can get them to at least go through the motions of playing correctly, and whether the form or not is another story, but you at least get them to get up on a horse and the whole thing, right?
Yeah, so the majority of people that start playing polo don't start in their you know, teens and at early ages. It's something that you pick up as a hobby over, you know, when you're, you know, established in life, you've got the kids, you know, maybe the kids are out of the house and you're looking for something to do. And so polo is really for everybody. It's something that you can pick up when you're, you know, 41 years old, say, and even 50, 60 years old. We have some guys that start at 60 years old, you know, and it's something that, you know, post-retirement, they're looking for something fun to do with their time. So we offer a wide array of options for people getting into the sport and, you know, how competitive you want to play. The possibilities are endless for.
So we're here in this barn that you guys have, where inside you, Turner, you said that this is like probably what, one third the size of like the outdoor space?
Yeah, it's probably about a quarter of the space you would get in an outdoor field. As you can see, it's massive.
Yes, I thought it was massive, but you guys said it's like, you said equivalent to 9 football fields, right?
The outdoor field is 300 yards long by 180 yards wide, and it is, so it's 9 football fields in one. So that's why we rely on our equine athletes to take us the distance of the field.
For sure. And Jenna, you started me off with just giving me the basics of the club or the hammer? The hammer.
Right? Mallet.
Oh, I got close. Darn it.
Close. Yeah, so I started you with the foot mallet. Mm-hmm. I learned the swing, learned how to hold it, parts of the mallet, and then
hitting it back and forth.
Hitting it back and forth, passing, learning. You know, some people want to hit it like a croquet mallet. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they got to hit with the whole head of the mallet.
Yeah, so for us who don't know what you're talking about, it means like the side of it versus not the front. So it's kind of, I would equate it to when you're young, you kick a soccer ball with your toe and you're not supposed to. You're supposed to kick with the inside of your foot. Same type of deal, right?
Yes, correct.
So you do that and then you get on Thunderbolt. Tell me about Thunderbolt here.
Very solid, easy, quiet. It's our wooden horse. He's stationary. You learn the swing, where to go in the saddle, how to position yourself. Where to position the mallet.
Where to put your feet, right?
Put your feet, where to put your hands, everything. And he's really great because he just stands there. And you can see where the ball has to be when you go to hit the ball. And we get you out there, we get you swinging. You got to find that swing.
I think that one of the most important things to talk about in terms of hitting the ball is where to hit the ball in the process of where you're on the horse. You said by your foot, right?
Yeah, you want to hit when you're doing the forward.
Or line it up with your foot.
Yeah, you want to hit it when it's just right about in front of your foot. So that's where the mallet is going to meet the ground perfectly. Mm-hmm. All the mallets have an angle to them. So as you swing down, it comes parallel to the ground, and that's the best spot where you can hit the ball.
So once you've mastered the old Thunderbolt, then you get up on Polly.
Yes.
Right?
Polly, yes, one of my favorite school horses. Very quiet, small, short to the ground, but this one moves.
Yes, she does move, but it was okay. It was safe and easy for me, and I had no idea what I was doing. But I still felt very safe with her, and you did great with her in terms of helping me train. Where you talked about the line, the ball line. Explain why that's important.
Yes, so one of the biggest rules in polo that you're going to come across is the line of the ball. That's not what you think it is. And the right of way. So it's the line of the ball is basically like, you're driving down the highway and you have those double yellow lines. Mm-hmm. You cannot cross in front of somebody that is coming down the line. You can't steal the ball from them. If it's going to create a dangerous situation, it's going to be a foul. And that's a very important rule to know as when you're starting out. So when we do start playing slow chuckers, you guys are safe. You understand where you're supposed to be, how to get there, what to do when you're there.
And Turner, you were up on the horse, you doing your thing, and you made it look really easy. I mean, the idea, I didn't know, I guess you hit the ball as hard as you can, as far as you can in certain spots, right?
It's kind of like golf, right? If you swing at it like a crazy man, it's not going to go anywhere. So there is you find that sweet spot in, you let the club do the work, the mallet do the work, just like you would in golf, you're letting the club do the work. But yeah, I've been playing polo since I was, 5, 6 years old. So it's something that I'm 25 now, so that's 19 years in the making. But it's something that you can get good at rather quickly. You can kind of be proficient in it in a matter of 6 to 12 months, if you put the time in.
And that's the whole goal, is to start here, start outside right here, and then you go into what would you guys call them? The match or?
Tournament games.
Yeah. So explain what that's like.
So the tournament games are it's full competitive, no holds barred polo, it's the most true form of it that's been played for centuries and centuries. It's one of the oldest team sports in the world, so it's
It's been around for a while.
Yeah.
And I didn't realize, Jenna, you were telling me that it can get a little, not aggressive, but you get a little bump. It's like racing, where they say Rubbin's racing, where you bump into each other. That's totally fine, legal. You can even smack the other mallet, right?
Yes, you can hook someone else's mallet. Mm-hmm. You can bump someone as long as you're knee to knee, shoulder to shoulder. It's totally legal. Ride it off. Push them away from the line of the ball. Push them away from the play. But so yeah,
does it get rowdy?
It
when
gets
you do
a little
that?
Rowdy. Oh, yeah. It gets aggressive. Yeah.
Who gets more aggressive, the riders or the horses?
Definitely the riders.
Before I forget, what's the one you got? A ball. That's the outside ball right there, right?
Door ball right here. Yep. It's a little.
So it's harder.
Harder plastic.
Okay.
Smaller. A little bit harder to hit sometimes.
What would you say is a little? Is it easier or harder to ride inside than outside?
Easier to ride inside for sure.
Yeah.
That's why we begin everybody in here, because it's a controlled environment. You get some people, they get on a horse and horses react to your vibe, I guess you could say. And if you have kind of an electric vibe to yourself, then the horse will pick up on that and they'll start to move a little quicker than the other horses.
Uh-huh.
And so in here we can kind of shut you in and
while it fails, you got a wall.
Yeah, we'll catch you.
Yeah. So for classes, for people who want to take this training that you guys offer, what's the best way for them to do that?
So if you want to reach out to me at jenna@oakbrookpoloacademy.com, I can send you all the details, all the pricing. We offer a 10-lesson group package, and you have 6 weeks to use that lesson. I'm accepting riders all ages. I have a junior group Wednesday, Friday, and I have an adult group that runs 5 days a week.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much, guys. I can't wait to see the end result when we go out to the match, the competitive gaming. I'll just watch from that one, though. I will. But this was definitely a lot of fun. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, no problem. All right, definitely knocking something off the bucket list that I didn't even know was on the bucket list. But I got to say, learning polo is pretty awesome. tbarnas@wgntv.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene, that's tbarnas@wgntv.com. And as always, thanks for watching, everybody. Let's see if we can find one more friend of mine. There you go.